At this time, we are going to begin our program, A Christmas to Believe In. A Christmas to Believe In.
A long time ago, in the town of Bethlehem, a Savior was born, which is Christ the Lord.
Wait a minute. What are you doing?
What do you mean, what am I doing? We're doing a Christmas play. You know that. What's the matter with you? Look around you. Everyone's here. Our parents are even here. Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mia.
Well, you see, I've been thinking about it, and I don't know if I believe in it all or not.
What? Don't believe it? Are you kidding me? What don't you believe?
I don't know if I believe in the Christmas story.
Ugh.
Well, when I was younger, I believed in Santa Claus, and you know what happened there.
Oh man, this is worse than I thought.
Here, take some deep breaths. It's supposed to help.
Wait, I have an epitome.
You mean an epiphany?
Whatever. I'll tell you the story of Christmas, and you can decide if you believe it or not. But whether you believe it or not, it's still true. And the really good thing is, since it's true, no one can ever take it away from you.
All right. If you think it helps, thanks.
Let's do it. A while back, there was a young woman named Mary.
Hi, Mary.
Hi. Do you believe yet?
I don't know. Is she supposed to be talking to me?
Mary lived in a town called Nazareth. The town is still there. You can go see it.
Oh, thanks.
Mary was promised to be married to a man named Joseph.
Lucky guy.
Quiet. One day, Mary was visited by an angel of God.
Now see, right there, an angel here on earth talking to some girl named Mary. I mean, there's no archaeological proof of that.
Did you have breakfast?
Yes, cereal.
Do you have archaeological proof of that?
No.
My point exactly. So this angel says to Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
sound like a strange greeting to you?
I imagine that's what Mary thinks. She looks really scared.
Don't be afraid, Mary. Though you have found favor with God, you will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save all his people from their sins.
Well, how would this be, since I'm a virgin?
Oh, I know this one. I took her class.
The angel is still speaking.
The Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, so the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
That's not what they told us in hell class.
I told you. The angel is still speaking.
Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a baby in her old age, for nothing is impossible with God.
It's amazing what they can do in those infertility clinics.
Dude, this all took over 2,000 years ago.
Sorry, my bad. Who's this Elizabeth chick anyway? Did you skip a page?
Wait, Mary has one more line.
May it be unto me as you have said, I am the Lord's servant.
Then the angel left her. And then Mary got ready and hurried to the town in the hill country of Judea to see her relative Elizabeth.
Hey, where she's going? Who's this Elizabeth chick?
Elizabeth was Mary's older cousin who lived in another town. She had been married to a good man named Zachariah for many, 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 many years.
Strange. She doesn't look that old.
This is an actress. Months earlier, the angel had visited Elizabeth's husband, Zachariah.
Dude, I knew you skipped a page.
The angel had visited Elizabeth's husband Zachariah when he had come to sacrifice at the temple.
What's the temple?
Like church, but before Jesus.
Oh.
The angel said,
hey, is that the same angel?
Yes, it is. See? It was the same angel. We like to try and stay close to reality as we can here.
Oh, yeah. I can see your angel seems a lot like the real thing.
The angel said to Zachariah,
don't be afraid, Zachariah.
Your angel seems to say that a lot.
Actually, angels are quite imposing figures. You can look it up in various passages in the Bible where angelic appearances are recorded. Almost all of them reflect how frightened they became.
Dude, are you all right?
Anyways, they end up having to say it almost every time.
Say what?
Don't be afraid.
Zachariah, your prayers have been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you are to give him the name John. He will be a joy and a light to you, and many will rejoice because of his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and he will help to make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
How can I be sure of this? I'm an old man, and my wife is well along in years.
Wow! Did you hear that? He called his wife old. Dude, is he in trouble?
Oh, he did something worse than that. He questioned an angel. Watch this.
I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and tell you this good news. And now you will be silent and not be able to speak until this day happens, because you did not believe my words, which will come true at the proper time.
to his voice.
Gone.
Longitis.
Power of God.
Wow.
You said it.
Well, it's sure that Zachariah didn't say it.
Sure enough, just like the angel had said, Zachariah and Elizabeth were soon expecting their first baby, despite their old age, but Zachariah still couldn't speak. It wasn't very long at all before Mary came to visit her cousin Elizabeth.
Elizabeth!
About 3 months, and then Mary went back to her hometown, Nazareth.
Bye, Mary.
Bye. Do you believe yet?
I don't know.
When Elizabeth's time came, she was delivered of a baby boy, just as the angel had told Zachariah.
Thank you.
When it was time to name the baby, their friends and neighbors asked them, suddenly, Zachariah could speak again.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Wow, all that time in silence must have given him time to think about what he would say.
And John grew up and became a great man of God, just like the angel had said. And later he would be known as John the Baptist.
He was a Baptist?
Let's not get into that right now. And so, that's the end of part one. Do you believe yet?
I don't know.
Well, let's listen to some music, and then we'll have part two.
Will Mary be back?
Oh, I'm sure she will. She has a pretty big part to fill.
All right, then.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered would soon deliver you. Oh, Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the sea with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. How Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know? No, no. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live. The dumb will
found Joseph, the man pledged to marry Mary, asleep in his bed. Joseph has had a hard day because as soon as Mary got back from visiting with Elizabeth, it was obvious to everyone that she was going to have a baby.
Uh-oh.
Yep. Now, Joseph was a very good man, and so he wanted to be kind and generous towards Mary. But since he knew the baby wasn't his, he wasn't sure what to do next. While he was still considering his options, an angel of the Lord came to him in a dream.
Oh no, not this guy again. Didn't you have anyone else to want to play an angel?
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son. You ought to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to her son and gave him the name Jesus.
By union, do you mean?
Yep, just like in health class.
Hi, Mary.
Hi. Do you believe yet?
I don't know.
Here. You read a while.
Why?
Because my mouth is tired. I've been reading all night.
Well, that's for sure. Where do you leave off? Oh, here it is. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that everyone in the Roman world would be counted. Why on earth would somebody order a stupid thing like that?
Tax base.
Oh, now I get it. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married with him and was expecting a child. Hey, is this almost over? Because I'm getting hungry. Are there going to be cookies?
Yes, there are going to be cookies. Of course there are going to be cookies. There's always cookies. Now read!
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave her firstborn son a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in the manger because there was no more room in the inn. Hi, Mary.
Hi. Do you believe yet?
I don't know. But you have a very nice baby.
Thank you. He's the Son of God.
And that's the end of part two.
Time for cookies.
Time for songs.
Well, of course, beloved, we have come to the end of another Great Awakenings broadcast. And as always, it is my prayer that what you have seen and heard today has been a source of inspiration as well as information to empower you in your walk with the Lord. Let me extend a personal invitation to you to join us right here at the St. James Missionary Baptist Church. St. James Church is located 527 East Thomas Street, just off of Raleigh Boulevard in the city of Rocky Mountain. Join us each and every Sunday morning for Sunday morning prayer at 9:30 a.m., Sunday school at 9:45 a.m., and our morning worship experience, which begins promptly at 11 o'clock a.m. For more understanding of the Word of God, we have Bible study each Tuesday evening at 6:30 p.m. and our midday Bible study on Thursday mornings at 11:30 a.m. If you're in the Rocky Mount area and desire transportation to our worship services on Sunday, all you'll have to do is call our transportation department using the information as you see it listed there on the screen. Someone will make contact with you and will ensure your safe arrival to church on Sunday morning and a safe return home at the end of our worship experience. If today's broadcast has been a blessing to you and you desire to have it on a CD or DVD, our media outreach ministry stands ready to assist you. All you'll have to do is call using the information as you see it, and please be sure to request the service number as it is listed on the screen. Someone from our administrative department will make contact with you and will assist you in obtaining your copy of today's worship service for your continued inspiration in the Word of God. As we come to the close of this broadcast, it is my prayer that your life has been blessed, it has been empowered and inspired by the Word of God. Let me give a personal hello and good morning to the staff and residents of the Hunter Hill Nursing and Rehabilitation Center, along with those who are viewing the Great Awakenings broadcast in hospitals, nursing homes, convalescent homes, and in their private sick homes. As always, our prayer for you is that God would keep you in a perfect peace as you keep your mind stayed on Him. Until next Saturday, we return with another Great Awakenings broadcast. Again, may the blessings of the Lord be with you now, henceforth, and always. Have a blessed day.